Yesterday, we had an on-air debate during this hour involving the new tentative SAG-AFTRA agreement with film and TV producers. Sophia Bush joined us to say she did not think the new deal was doing enough to protect actors on the set.
Understand why, for so many of us who have been through unsafe working conditions, we're being told that staying in the game should be enough. We are 3 years into the explosion of Me Too. We are 2 years into the creation of Time's Up, who, by the way, gave SAG all of the legal language they needed to go in and advocate with the studios. SAG then announced a code of conduct was coming. And we don't have it. We didn't get it. And we're not asking for anything outlandish here. We're asking to protect our performers at their most vulnerable.
All right. Time's Up, the advocacy group for women, has weighed in saying they agree with Sophia. There are those who feel differently. One of the first people to speak out about her experiences during the Me Too movement is an actress. Her name is Chantal Cousineau.
I came forward in the Me Too movement at the very beginning, and I've heard over 1,000 voices share their experience on what happened to them on sets and auditions in the pursuit of work in this industry. And I took those voices to the union, and many other people went directly to the union. And with that, we brought our most, you know, pressing concerns to the AMPTP. In this particular position, I think we went in really strongly and we ended up with a lot of protections. And I am not, I am in a strong position that we should not be gambling with those protections because they speak to a lot of pain, a lot of fear. And for me in particular, I changed my entire career. I walked away from film and television and I did television commercials. And I changed the way that I approached my career because of what happened to me. So I want people to, you know, go to SAG-AFTRA.org and get the facts of this contract, get, you know, the details, the data, and really make a decision based on what is there on paper and not some misinformation.
Voting deadline is tomorrow, and there are websites essentially advocating both points of view.